What's up, everyone? Marc Lobliner, tigerfitness.com. I just wanted to I'm sorry, this wasn't planned. Look at how sweaty. You could tell how sweaty my shirt is. I'm gonna have to burn this. Look, oh God, this is fucking, hello, ladies. It's nasty as fuck. Anyway, you saw at the beginning of this video, I'm gonna splice it in there. I decided to turn my camera on, turn my DMX off. And look how sweaty this hat is. You can't even turn the DMX off and get a little video of me deadlifting. And I gotta say, it was a hell of a workout today. And just want to give you guys an update on what's going on, other than the shreds, what's going on here. And just want to get it fresh. I literally just came in the door from the gym. It's like 10:15 p.m. Got to the gym at like 8, did my 20 minutes of step mill, did a little under 2 hours of back. Just great workout, great people, great day. I'm not going to say exactly what I'm doing, but I will say that I am getting some medical stuff done. And I'm really excited about what I'm finding out about myself. And, you know, it's something that I just wanted to kind of go over. I mean, my EKG is perfect, which is great. Blood pressure is perfect. Got all my blood work done, urine, all that stuff. Everything's on point. And I got some psych evaluation done, which is something I want to share with you guys. Because I mean, you guys know that. I just want you to know my personality type, and according to, you know, testing, is that I'm lovable, I'm caring, and I'm also, obviously, I'm a leader. And I got my IQ test. I'm not going to say what it is, but let's just say it's high, which might surprise a lot of you trolls. But, you know, looking at my success in business and stuff, I never got my IQ tested before, because I always had a thought that if it's high, I'm going to become a cocky bastard. And if it's low, I'm just going to limit myself thinking, well, my IQ's low. What the hell? You know, I got a PR in deadlifts. I got 600 pounds for 2 reps, a week out from my show. I don't think I've ever gotten 600 pounds at the end of a back workout. It was an epic workout. My diet, you know what? I wish it was better. I mean, you guys can go to my Snapchat at Marc Lobliner and see the kind of food I'm eating. It's clean. It's healthy, but it's not measured out. It's not perfect. And 2 weeks out from a show, that's really not acceptable. But you know what? If you have an opportunity like I have in front of me, you got to do what it takes to take it. Now, I'm not saying it's 100% sure. I'm saying that, you know, if it happens, great. If it doesn't happen, you know what? I tried. And that's something. Now, I will say that, you know, I'm having a bit of issues. Like Thomas acted out in school the other day, and it's because I'm not there. And he misses me. And, you know, I travel a lot to begin with. So, I mean, you know, it's tough being away from home, but it is what it is. I got my tan booked for my show. My strength is there. What's really tough for me in this situation is I'm literally in this hotel room 21 hours a day. Literally out of 24 hours, I'm here 21 hours. And it's tough for me. I'm getting a lot of work done, but it's really hard. For someone who's such a busybody, who gets around, who does his thing, to sit in a hotel room and do this. So I got to say that I'm blessed to have this. I'm blessed to have opportunities, and the companies are going great. I mean, you know, can't really say enough stuff. And I'd like to just let you guys know that I'm appreciative of everything. You know, I went on Facebook and Twitter tonight. I said, you know what? I've been locked in my room all day long. I just need a little bit of motivation. And I had the nicest motivational emails, texts, as well as just posts on Facebook and Twitter. The support has been unreal. The mean people have really come out on YouTube. It's a very low percentage, but it just seems like when they sense the slightest hint of success, they come out. I mean, this one, I'm just going to leave the comments up, and I encourage you guys to read the comments to just counterattack these people, because I really just don't feel like blocking people anymore. I'm kind of over it. People coming out against my kids and my wife and stuff like that. I just don't understand why, even if you don't like somebody, why you would do that. You know, my wife is, you know, she's not from this industry. She's had 3 kids. I don't expect her to be in bikini model shape, nor should anybody else. And that's not her lifestyle. She trains, she eats healthy, and she's a very healthy person. All her health parameters are extremely healthy. I don't understand why you guys would say anything, you know, mean, but I'm not going to delete it. You know what I mean? It's like, she's very comfortable in who she is, and I'm comfortable with who she is too. And that's that, you know, been with my wife for 18 years. I don't really expect, you know what? People are mean. So it is what it is. I'll get over it. It's not the first time people have said mean things about myself or my family. To call my kids ugly, you know, I would like to say that if I ever see who says this in person, you know, I'm going to fucking kill you with my bare hands. No, I'm not going to kill anybody. No, I'm not going to do anything. At the end of the day, I'm not going to touch you. But why would you do that? You know, that's takes a really sad person, a really sad, insecure, pathetic person to do that. Just like the people who came on the Order 66 trolls, and I know I'm calling for a load of shit by saying this, but you really got to look at where you're at in life to come at someone and come at someone's family and say mean things about them, and how low your self-esteem is and what your personality chart is. And the fact that if you just took the psych exams that I have taken this week, that you would fail, and you're a miserable, pathetic, sad person. And that's just a sad thing. And I really, you know what, I'm going to say this. I pray for you. I pray that one day you will come along and you will realize what a sad, pathetic individual you are, and you will change and become a contributor to society who isn't just leeching off of society, who is actually contributing. But I will say that I'm not going to harm anybody. I haven't been in a fight since I was 16 years old. I ain't going to fight anybody. If somebody hits me first, sure, I'll strike you back, but I have too much to lose to get in a fight. So I encourage you to say it to my face, because I'm not going to do anything. Everybody's like, well, what if Vegan Gains comes? I'm not going to touch him. I don't need him to sue me. I mean, I'm not stupid. I have a lot to lose. He lives in his mother's basement. Why would I give a fuck about him? You know, these vlogs are really weird, because I get to get kind of a little bit deep, a little bit emotional. You know, at the end of the day, guys, I mean, why would you be negative? Why would you waste your time and energy being negative when you could do positive things for society? You know, like right now with Ronnie Coleman, we're giving money to the Wounded Warriors families. I'm putting on a bodybuilding show June 25th. I'm going to try and get Kai there. I know Ronnie's already committed to being there. Doug Miller is going to be there. I'm obviously going to be there emceeing. We're doing an OCB show, the Tiger Fitness Uprising, on June 25th in Mason, Ohio. Mark your calendars. We're going to have the biggest star power in the history of natural bodybuilding. And you know what? Every bit of proceeds from that show is going towards the Mason Middle School, which we're going to support our local middle school, and the other half is going towards the Semper Fi Fund. You know, why wouldn't you take that time and energy that you give towards hatred and vile and put it towards greatness and put it towards helping people? Because you have time. You're on the internet, okay? Why don't you donate that time you're on the internet saying mean things about myself and my family, and go donate your time to a food bank? Go help with kids in a middle school. Go read to kids. Go read to you know, kids who come from, you know, drug infested households. Go do stuff. Go help people. You know, I just don't understand. I really don't. And the thing is, these Order 66 kids, you know, they came on my Instagram. I know I shouldn't even mention them. Don't mention the trolls, Mark. But I really feel for them, and I think I can help them. And call me an asshole if I'm being wrong about it. But think about it. I see them. These are 15, 16-year-old kids who are spewing vile and hatred towards me, towards my family, towards my employees, towards everybody involved. Dude, at 15, 16 years old, you can make a difference. You could be a big brother to somebody who needs help. These kids have money. I see their Instagrams, you know. It's pictures of them. They play high school football. I've seen these kids. And it's pathetic. And then they make these little things. It pisses. It's sick. It's like, really? I know you're young, but this is a time when your mind is developing. Develop into something great. Look, I've made mistakes in my life. I ran with the wrong crowd before. But you know what? At the end of the day, I never, ever, ever said the vile shit that these kids say. And it just scares me about society and the society I'm raising my children in, that this is our future, that this is our future of our country, of our world. These faceless, nameless cowards are the future. And that scares me. That scares the daylights out of me. Okay? I don't even know what to say. I don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about anymore. It's supposed to be an inspirational vlog, and it just turned out to be sad. Fuck. I'm all up in my feelings, bro. Anyway, guys, tomorrow's a new day. I'm going home Friday. See my wife and kids. All you people talking mad shit, look yourself in the mirror and just realize that you're wasting your time. You're wasting your life. You know, I work 20 hours a day towards positivity. Hopefully what I just said, if one person listens to this and realizes that they're doing something that maybe isn't right for themselves, for society, that's great. Or this could cause a whole Order 66 friggin' avalanche on me. I've had worse. I'm Marc Lobliner, tigerfitness.com. There's my vlog. It was depressing. But the deadlifts were fucking awesome, and that's not a game.